if you need your healing, you know, if you know somebody who needs their healing, if a family member needs their healing, feel free to tell them to get on before we get started. Tell them to get on because God is really going to move in our midst. You know, if you're a group of people, just put it on speaker and let God move. All you need is faith. And you don't have to do anything special with that faith. You being on the line is all the faith you need. That's you coming to Christ, you know, and he'll touch you. I won't touch you, but he'll touch you through his angels. But before we get started, I'm going to give the line over to our brother Obi to lead us in some worship. And as he leads us in worship, I'll do open in prayer, then we'll hear a testimony, and then we'll get into the service. Obi, I give it to you.
Father, we love you, we worship, we adore you, glorify your name in all the
in prayer.
Gathered here for me, they're gathered here for you, to feel you, to know you, to experience you, to have you demonstrate your power and your love. I pray that you move like you've never moved before. We take control of the atmospheres. We take control of the third heavens, of the first and the second heavens. We pray that the power of God flow. We command these atmospheres to be conducive for the operations of the Holy Spirit. We break through every limitation. We break through every hindrance. We break through every fear, every doubt, every spirit of slumber and distractions. We come against you this moment in the name of Jesus, Christ of Nazareth, he who died and rose on the third day. We shall not be hindered, nor shall we be limited. Lord, I pray that your word flow. Let it proceed like the rivers of living water. Let my voice be likened to the voice of many waters. Give me utterance in the name of Jesus. Amen. And amen. I thank you guys for being on the line tonight. I already feel the power of God moving so heavily in our midst. I feel them. But before we get into our topic and into the healings, I said every day we'll be having a testimony of what God has done to people during these 77 days, during the midst of the 77 days, what he's done for people on this prayer line, what he's done for people and their families, what he's done to them and through them. And tonight we're going to have our brother Eric share with us his testimony of what God did in his life. So, Eric, I give it to you.
Hello, everybody. Praise the Lord. I'll make my testimony really quick. So, I think my grandmother, it's about my grandmother, she had a doctor's appointment, and I guess it was just a regular checkup, but then I guess they found something in her liver. They were trying to say it was cancerous. So they did some tests on it. There's like some tests they did with like, it was like between 2.5 and 5. 2.5 was saying it was like a benign, or above 5 was saying it was cancerous. It was like the highest score you can get for it to be at like a cancerous level. So when they screened her, they were trying to say she had cancer. My mom was with her at the time, so she told my siblings as well about it. And at the time, I wasn't worried or anything. I didn't want her going through like chemotherapy or anything, because I know that's not what God had in store for her. So I just asked God, what did he want me to do? And I had some anointing oil, and God was just anoint her room and see if you can anoint her if you can. So I asked if I can anoint her. She said, yeah. So we prayed. We read the word of God. We trusted in what God, told us. I anointed her room. I left it at that. This was like in mid-July. So I think it was around last week. My grandma went back. They were trying. It was like a test before the chemotherapy was supposed to start. And they did the test again. And the cancer was gone. The doctors couldn't figure out what happened during that period of time. They were looking at each other. They ran the test multiple times. Each time they said the cancer was removed. So we give God all the glory and all the honor and all the praise for what he's done in my grandmother's life.
Amen and amen and amen. That is a wonderful testimony. Healing from cancer. There's one of those things that when people hear about it, they go into depression. And when people hear about it, they're afraid, and it's basically a death sentence. But as a child of God, you know that your life is not seated in what happens to you. It's not in what the enemy brings to your family. It's not in the sicknesses and diseases that surround you. You being able to live is not rooted in yourself, but it's in Christ. And as he went to his grandmother and he anointed her and he prayed for her, the power of God flowed through her. And that's why I tell everybody on this line, on this fast. You understand? If he never had the faith to do that, if he never heard from God to begin with, he wouldn't have been able to do that. And that comes from a place of dedication and commitment to God. When you sit down and you build yourself in the spirit, you build your faith. And you don't just do it to do it. A lot of anybody could have anointed her, and it would still be cancerous. But through the fasting and his prayer for life, the light in him shined into her darkness and transformed her and healed her of her sickness. And for those of you on this line, for those of you who are fasting with us, understand that though you may not feel anything physically, I need you to know that God is empowering you, that God is strengthening you, that God is lifting you up. He's increasing you. And once he builds up your faith, you can go out and demonstrate that power of God. No matter how many years you've been in Christ, no matter how many years you've been committed and dedicated, next month will mark one full year that I've been completely dedicated to Christ. So it's not a matter of years. It's not a matter of how old you are. It's a matter of dedication and service and obedience. Obedience to Christ. So that's a great testimony. And we're going to get into our word for the evening. And as I said, that this night is a night of healing and deliverance, but mostly centered on healing. I wanted us to talk about something, you know? Talk about it. Let's just talk about it. We're going to talk about the name of Jesus, the name above every other name. One of the reasons why there's been a lack in miracles, and there's been a lack in the power of God, there's been a lack in the glory of God, there's been a lack in the church, in the kingdom of, not in the kingdom, in the church world, in these religious institutions, there's no power, there's no healings, there's no miracles, there's no deliverance, and we ask ourselves, why is this happening? And it is because there is nobody preaching on Jesus. There is nobody preaching on the name of Jesus. As we read the day before yesterday about Evangelist Philip, when he went to the city of Samaria, he preached to them Jesus, and those who were sick, they were healed, and those who were possessed, the demons cried out of them, leaving them. So when you don't preach the name of Jesus, when you don't preach Jesus, when you talk about yourself, when you lift up yourself, when you glorify your own name, when you get up on the pulpit and it's all about you and your church and your ministers, then there's no power of God. Because the Holy Spirit will not confirm you. Remember, the duty of the Holy Spirit on this earth is to glorify Jesus. So if you're glorifying yourself, don't expect the Holy Spirit to move and do healings and miracles and deliverances. Because when he does it, that's not a glory to Jesus, but it's a glory to you. But when you sit down and you talk to somebody and you tell them, look, it's not me, it's Jesus who does the work. And it's Jesus who will set you free. It's Jesus who will heal you. It's Jesus who will transform your life. It's Jesus. I can sit here and I can yell from morning to night. I can sit here and I can debate from morning to night. But when I call on that name of Jesus, things begin to happen because there is power in his name. Jesus in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Philippians chapter 2 from verses 9 to 11. And it says, wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every other name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven and of things on earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and to the glory of God the Father. See, you have to understand that before Jesus had his name exalted, first you have to go to the beginning. Because in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. Same thing was in the beginning with God. All things. things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. Before the physical manifestation of Jesus on earth, he was not called Jesus. He was called the Word. There are three that bear witness in heaven: the Father, the Spirit, and the Word. He was not known as Jesus. He was known as the Word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And that flesh that he dwelt among us, we call him Jesus. His name shall be Jesus. Now before his name was exalted, he had to be obedient to the will and plans and the orchestrations and the destiny of God, his assignment in this earth. And it says, wherefore God hath highly exalted him. Remember, the Bible says that God will make our names great, not our titles great. A lot of times we want to elevate ourselves beyond what God has elevated us to be. We wanna puff up ourselves because we got a little anointing, and we got a little revelation, we got a little power, and we think we're all that, and we puff ourselves up. But Jesus never puffed himself up, even though when we saw him, we saw the Father. And it says, at that name of Jesus, every knee should bow, with things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. It didn't say some knees. It said every knee should bow. Every knee should bow. The principalities and the power, they have to bow at the name of Jesus. The demons must bow at the name of Jesus. Your sicknesses, your afflictions, your diseases, at the name of Jesus. They have no choice. It's not an option. It is not an option. They have to bow at the name of Jesus. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. And every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So you have to understand that every knee should bow. I don't care what you're going through in life. I don't care who your enemy is. I don't care who's doing witchcraft to you. I don't care who's attacking you, what demon is attacking you when you're asleep. I don't care the principality. I don't care the curses that your family is under. At that name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. They don't have an option. But the biggest problem with the believers in this generation is that we think that the things we do them by ourselves, when we don't understand that if you do those things by yourself, the moment that you're weak, you can't do them anymore, and the enemy has an advantage over you. But no, we do these things through the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If you understand where your foundation is rooted on, you understand that nothing can happen to you that Jesus cannot deliver you from. No sickness will come your way, and you'll see cancer and you'll treat it like a common cough. You'll say, oh, it's just cancer, because in the name of Jesus, the name of cancer must bow. So it's nothing. And you have anemia, or you have a tumor in your belly, or you have a sickness or a disease or HIV or AIDS or malaria or tuberculosis or whatever it is, you have it. And you say it's nothing, because at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, not in my name. I'm here to tell you, it's not in the name of Ugo, it's not in my name, for I am a mortal man just like you. I am but a servant doing that which is my duty. But I come to you not in myself, but I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And in his name, everything shall bow. They don't have an option. It's not a choice. In the name of Jesus, everything shall bow. And you say, okay, what does this name of Jesus do for me? This name of Jesus, it gives you salvation. Acts 4:12 says, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Your salvation is not a result of your church. Some churches will make you feel as if as soon as you leave that church, as soon as you leave that denomination, you're not saved anymore, but that's a lie from the pit of hell. Your salvation is not rooted in the church you go to. It's not rooted in your pastor. It's not rooted in your apostle. It's not rooted in your mentor. Your salvation is in Christ. It's in the name of Jesus. For neither is there salvation in any other. And if your salvation is in Christ, then it can never be shaken, so you don't have any reason to question your salvation. Regardless of what life brings your way, regardless of what the enemy tries to attack you with, you'll understand that your salvation is rooted in Christ, is rooted in Jesus. So you cannot be shaken, for the name of Jesus is above every other name. He is a being that sits in the third heavens next to the throne of the Father, forever interceding for the sins. That throne cannot be moved. He cannot be shaken. So your salvation, it cannot be stripped away from you. I don't care what you're going through. I don't care what's going on in your life. I don't care what somebody said to you, what somebody did to you, but you must understand that your salvation is in Christ alone. It's in His name that you receive your salvation. And I said that the reason why there are barely any more miracles and healings, that people come up on the platforms and they're not even pulpits, they're not altars, they're stages now. They're stages for performances. They just go there and act a fool, and people get up on those stages and they preach everything besides the name of Jesus. They preach everything besides Jesus. So they get up there to have entertainment and to have fun, but they neglect the reason why they should be up there to begin with, because Acts 4:30, and it says, by stretching forth thine hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done in the name of the Holy Child Jesus. Signs and wonders are done in the name of Jesus. They're not done in the name of that prophet that you like. They're not done in the name of that evangelist that you like. They're not done in the name of that preacher that you like. That person who gets up on a platform and yells and yells and gets on a chair and gets you sweaty and hype. They're not done in His name, but signs and wonders and miracles are done in none other but the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, He who died and rose on the third day. And I want you to understand that there are a lot of Jesuses, but there's only one Jesus Christ of Nazareth. There's only one who died and rose on the third day. There's only one who is exalted above all creation. There's only one, and His name is Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah, the Anointed One of Israel. In Mark 16:17-18, and it says, these signs shall follow them that believe in my name, this is Jesus speaking. He said, in my name they shall cast out devils, they shall speak with new tongues, they shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly drink, it shall not hurt them, they shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. I'm telling you this evening, why are you so afraid to pray for people to get their healing? Why are you so afraid to cast out devils? Why are you so afraid to stand in the presence of the enemy and assert your dominion? But when you understand that it's not you, but it's Christ, then your faith will never be shaken. For He says, these signs and wonders shall follow them that believe. It's a shame that in this generation we have people who follow the signs and wonders, but the signs and wonders don't follow them. You don't have to have a follower of 300,000 for you to operate in signs and wonders. It could be that one person who's sick next to you. It could be that one person, that one family member who's in the hospital and they can be near death. but you say no, no, no. The Bible says in this name, he, Jesus said in my name, these sons shall follow. And it says, they shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. And if they drink any deadly thing, we have people who are so afraid, so paranoid over the smallest things, over the sicknesses, over diseases, over the things they eat. And I'm all for being healthy and all of that. But when you're afraid to eat certain things because you feel as if you die, that's not God. But the word of God says, and if they drink any deadly thing, they shall not die. Yet there was a man, I believe this was Peter, and a serpent struck him. And the inhabitants of the island, they said, oh, he's about to die. But he took that serpent and he bit off its head. And he threw it in the fire. And they waited for hours and hours and hours. And the inhabitants of the island, they said, who is this man? Is he a god? For the serpent has struck him, it's bitten him, but he is not dead. But that's Peter. He understood that it was not in himself. His health is not in himself. It's not in how much good food he eats. It's not in all of that, but it's sustained through the name of Jesus. Because there are people who eat healthier than you, but they are more sickly. But it's in the name of Jesus, and the signs and wonders shall follow them that believe. So if you believe in his name, then you shall use his name to do those things which need to be done. You don't have to wait for him to come down from heaven himself. You don't have to wait for that bishop to come down and lay hands on you. You say, these signs and these wonders shall follow them that believe. Shall follow them that believe. And we're met with all types of circumstances and situations, and we find our solution in everywhere else besides the name of Jesus. Even when David was confronted with Goliath, David said, I come to you in the name of the Lord God of Israel. And a lot of you, you meet your situation, you meet your sickness and your circumstances, and you say, I come to you in the name of my doctor. You say, I come to you in the name of my accountant. I come to you in the name of myself and my psychiatrist. You say, I come to you, and you say all these names, but you wouldn't say the name of Jesus, and your circumstances in your situations will be laughing at you. But God is looking for a remnant that is going to wake up and look at the devil in his eye, who's going to wake up and look at those situations and say, who is this uncircumcised Philistine who stands in the land of the Most Holy, who stands in the presence of the Son of God? For you are a child of God. If you understand your position, you'll know who you are. You won't be battling with depression. You won't be battling with jealousy. You won't be battling with envy. You won't be battling with sickness, but you will look that thing in the eye and you'll say, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? You'll say, who is this who stands in my presence? Because you know that your power is not in yourself, but it's in the name of Jesus. In no other name but the name of Jesus. In no other name but the name of Jesus. And I'm going to pray for you guys this evening. And I'm not going to pray in my name, because I'm but a man like you. But I will pray for you in the name of Jesus, and you'll receive your healing. But I don't want it to stop there, you know. It's not about me. It's not about me. It's not about your pastor. That name of Jesus, it's usable by every believer. The biggest problem that we have is that we're afraid to take the step of faith, because we don't want to make ourselves look bad. We wouldn't pray for that person, because what if my prayers don't work? I don't want to make myself look bad. We wouldn't lay hands on the sick, because we'll say, what if I lay hands on them and nothing happens? I don't want to make myself look bad. And that is the issue. You're coming to your situations, you're coming to that problem in the name of yourself, and you're just putting a sticker of Jesus on it, but Jesus is not in it. Because if you understood the power in his name, you'll understand that everything you can do, Everything you'll ever say, every power you'll ever demonstrate is done in his name. And that's why Paul said, I come to you not in the enticing words of man's wisdom, but I come to you in the demonstration of spirit and power. We have too many preachers and teachers and too many people who get up on the altar and they come to you in the enticing words of man's wisdom. They'll talk your ear off from morning to night, but there's no demonstration of power because they just memorized and they just read the book of God to make themselves look good. They just memorized the Bible to make themselves sound good. They just get up on the altar to glorify themselves and they say that it's the name of Jesus, but you cannot be in a place operating in the name of Jesus. You cannot be in a place operating in the power of Jesus and there be no demonstration of spirit and power. If there's no demonstration, then God ain't in it. And we pick and choose which part of Christ we should operate under. We'll say, you know, God, Jesus loved everybody, so I gotta love everybody. But Jesus didn't just love everybody. He also casted out demons and healed the sick. But we'll say, no, that's not for me, that's for the pastor. No, that's not for me, that's for the apostle. No, that's not for me, that's for that prophet. I don't got to do that. I don't take all that. That's not my ministry. That's not my calling. But that is a lie, because if you want to walk like Jesus, you must walk like him in 100% in the fullest capacity that you know how to. You have to understand you cannot pick and choose what's part of Christ to operate in. He is God. You have to operate in him. If you're going to be a Christian, then you'll be a Christian. You be like Christ. That is why the early believers, they were called Christians, because they were like Christ. They operated like him. They walk like him. They talk like him. They casted out demons like him. They laid hands on the sick like him. They had compassion like him. They loved one another like him. But we are in this dispensation where we believe that, no, it's separate. I don't want to do that part, but I still want to be a Christian. I don't want to cast out devils. I don't want to pray for sick around me, but I still want to be a Christian. But look, Jesus said it, not me, not the pastor. Jesus said it. He said, these signs shall. He didn't say these signs might. He didn't say these signs, maybe they'll follow them that believe if they want them to. He didn't say that. He says, these signs shall follow them that believe, period. So if you are a believer and you have no signs following you, then there's an issue. If you are a believer and you have no demonstration following you, then there's an issue. What is the issue? I found it to be lack of knowledge. My people perish for lack of knowledge. We don't have understanding, because he didn't say these signs shall follow them that believe in their name. We think it's in our name, when that's a lie. He said, in my name. He made it easy for you. He made it easy for you. He said, in my name. In my name, in my name, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the signs and wonders shall follow them that believe, shall follow them that believe. That these signs and wonders shall follow them that believe in my name. They shall cast out devils in my name. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And that's exactly what Peter did. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. There was a popular preacher from my country, Nigeria, and he said that some armed robbers came to him, and they said, it's either you drink this poison or we shoot you. And he said, gladly, give me the poison. And he said, as he was drinking it, that poison was transformed into malt. I don't know if you've taken malt before, maltina. I love malt. It's awesome. And he says, as he was drinking it in his mouth, it was transformed like malt. And the assassins left, but he lived. And not only did he live, but he lived more abundantly, because he had just finished drinking a bottle of malt. So he was refreshed. He felt good. You understand? He felt good. And they thought they killed him until they saw him on TV the next day. If they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You see, the church has gotten to a place where it's so common for people to pray for people and nothing happens. It's so common for you to go to church and the pastor lay hands on you and nothing happens. It's so common for you to be in a gathering and all you do is yap, 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 but there's no power. It's so common for you to be in a place and all you do is argue, 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 but there's no power. There's no healing, there's no demonstration. But when somebody stands up and operates in the power of God, instead of asking them, teach me how to fish, we make them a star. And then they get puffed up and we begin to elevate their name instead of the name of Jesus that they're operating under. And Christ is raising a generation where everybody is demonstrating. You see, that's why I chose this fast for these people. If not, I would have just had the prayer line. But I said, no. God said, no, it's not about you. You go. I want to empower my people. I want to empower my children. I want them to demonstrate and operate like you doing even more. Because there are those of you on the line that will do more. And there are those of you who will be great. But you must be empowered to do it. And Christ is raising up a generation. It doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter how young you are. If you want to be a part of it, you can be a part of it. All you have to do is tell them that you want it. All you have to do is say, God, I want it. And understand that everything is done in the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus, the name above every other name. In his name every knee shall bow. In his name every tongue shall confess. In his name is your healing. Your deliverance is in his name. This prayer line is not what does it. It's the God of this prayer line that does it. I am not the person who does the healings and the miracles or the deliverances. Jesus said, if I by the finger of God, I by the finger of God in the name of Jesus. I am but a servant doing that which is my duty. But if I can share with you about the name of Jesus, you'll go out and you'll demonstrate even like I do. Because you'll know that it's not in you, it's not in how many years you've been in the church, it's not in your position and your title in the church, it's not in any of that, but it's solely in the name of Jesus, in his name. Because he died and he rose and he suffered and the provision has been made. And I said everything you'll ever need has been given to you, but you call it down by the name of Jesus. And there are certain people on this line, it's time for you to cry out to Jesus. I don't know who you've been crying out to before. I don't know who you've been talking to before. I don't know who you've made your confidence. But you need to make it Jesus. I don't know who's been praying for you before, but if they're not using the name of Jesus, then it's an issue. And that's why we have so many people confirming and they're denying Christ. And they'll call up a preacher to preach or to pray at a certain place. And they'll say, you can pray, but just don't say the name of Jesus. And that preacher will pray and he'll say, all this in your name, amen. And he'll leave. And Christians will be happy about it. But Jesus says whatever we ask of him in his name, it must be in his name that it's done. So if you're not doing it in the name of Jesus, if you're not praying in the name of Jesus, then it's an issue. It's not about religion. It's not about denomination. It's about the word of God. It says you must pray in the name of Jesus. And that is a difference between us believers and every other religion. Some people pray to Muhammad. Some people pray to Buddha. Some people pray to the idols and fallen angels. Some people pray to Mother Mary. But that's an issue because the Bible says in my name, if you ask anything of God in my name, it shall be done. And don't be fooled. All these religions, they claim to serve the same God as we serve, but they don't pray to the the same son that we pray to. And I'm here to share with you all about that beautiful name of Jesus. The name above all names. The name that's going to give you your healing this evening. He's already touching you. You may already feel his presence on you. That's the name of Jesus above all names. So I want to pray for you this evening. And I want you to understand that even after I pray for you and you receive your healing, that you go out and pray for others, because what I say, it's not on me, it's not by me, it's by the name that I use, it's in the name of Jesus. So if I can use it, then you can use it. There's nothing special about me. You can use it. I'm going to pray for you. And Christ is going to do the work. He's going to release his angels, and his angels are going to do the work. And we're going to have emotional healings. Emotional healings this evening. We're going to have physical healings, spiritual healings, and mental healings. But I'm going to mute the line for just 1 second, and I want you to cry out that name of Jesus. I want you to say, Jesus, it's all about you. I want you to say, Jesus, I need you. If you're sick, you say, Jesus, my healing is in your name. If you're depressed, you say, Jesus, my joy is in your name. If you're feeling down, you say, Jesus, my happiness is in your name. If you're being attacked, you say, Jesus, my deliverance is in your name. I just want you to cry out. Jesus, cry out that name of Jesus. Cry out the name of Jesus.
Glorify your Lord.
Glorify
nobody like you. Nobody
can
compare to you, Lord.
Jesus, we give you the glory.
Glorify you, Lord.
Jesus, we give you the adoration. Jesus. For it's all in your name, Father.
The living, the
it's all in your name,
O Lord.
Cry out that name above all names. Your healing is in his name. Your deliverance is in his name. Your breakthrough is in his name. It's not in me, it's in him. If you're seeking for something new, it's in his name. If you're seeking for a touch of God, you must call out to him. You must reach out to him. Tell him that you finally understand that it's in the name of Jesus and no other name. No other name I know. No other name. No other name but the name of Jesus. Jesus. Alleluia. I want you to close your eyes. Hallelujah. mouth sing this song, there's only one word. Alleluia. Close your eyes and the power of God is going to come upon you. Alleluia. Alleluia. He's already touching you. Alleluia. 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 Precious Jesus. Precious Jesus. Get into his presence. Precious Jesus. Lord, we invite you. Precious Jesus. Precious Jesus. Precious Jesus. Precious Jesus. Precious Jesus, precious Jesus, precious Jesus, precious Jesus, precious Jesus. Look, you don't need me to pray for you. Just get into his presence. He'll touch you. Even before I start praying, even before I start yelling, he'll touch you. Just close your eyes as tight as you can. Sing and get into the presence of Elohim. Holy Spirit. Yes, Father. Jesus, we invite you into our midst. Let your healing flow begin to touch your children. From the crown of their head to the soles of their feet, let your anointing begin to flow. Begin to flow. Begin to flow. Everybody, silence. Just be silent. Just close your eyes. And drink in that anointing that destroys the yoke. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, that at his name every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess. I see cancer, cancer, cancer. I speak to every person with cancer. Actually, I speak to every spirit of cancer. Every cancer, whether you are identified or not, whether they know you're there or not, or whether you're planning to come or not. And I command you to bow to the name of Jesus. Bow to the name of Jesus. I speak to every tumor and every fibroid. I speak to every lump, every cyst, and every growth. In the name of Jesus, I command you to melt and bow to his name. I speak to every emotional hurt and distress. In the name of Jesus, let there be a purification in the hearts of your children, Lord. Jesus, I pray that you touch them. He's touching somebody in the hearts. Every medical condition begins to bow to the name of Jesus. If you're sick, if you're sore, if you have a problem with one of your organs, just put your hand where that organ is. And Jesus will touch you. Yes, he'll touch you. If you have a sore or a pain in your body, begin to do something that you couldn't do before. As you do it, Jesus is going to touch you. He's here. He's here. He's here. He's here. Oh, Jesus. Release that same anointing that you've put on me right now. Release it to your children from the greatest to the least. Release it. Your healing virtue, release it. Your anointing, release it. Jesus, 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 we pray as you send your ministering angels to begin to do surgeries in their bodies. 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 I speak to every spirit of infirmity and affliction. And I command you to bow to the name of Jesus and leave. Bow to the name of Jesus and leave. Bow to the name of Jesus and leave. Every medical condition, bow to the name of Jesus and leave. Every spirit of torment and affliction, bow to the name of Jesus. He is our Father, the name above all names, of He, the name of He who died and rose on the third day, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. I speak to everything that is not of God under the sound of my voice, and I command you to bow to the name of Jesus. Yes, somebody's being touched. You're all being touched. The Lord is working in somebody's mind right now. You may feel a pressure in your head. He's working in your mind. Every spirit of doubt and fear and unbelief and sorrow and suicide and rejection and self-rejection and in their mind, I command you to bow to the name of Jesus and leave and leave and leave and leave. Loose your hold this moment in the name of Jesus. Lizi gabandele hara ala gabaduri bande gabalaganga. I speak to their bellies, their bellies, their bellies. Lord, you say out of their bellies shall flow rivers of living water. Everything in their bellies that is not of you, let it begin to bow to the name of Jesus. Let it begin to bow to the name of Jesus. Let it begin to bow to the name above every other name. Let it begin to bow to the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, I pray that you flow and glorify the name of Jesus. Every devil, every demon, Leave. Kabadi bahanda lagada baduli vagaya ndele bagaya. Every spirit of infirmity under the sound of my voice, leave. Kande ilagabada, ought not these children of Abraham be loosed? Children, thou art loosed from thy afflictions and infirmities. Thou art loosed from your anxiety. You are loosed from that spirit of jealousy. You are loosed from that spirit of anger. You are loosed from that spirit of lust and perversion. You are loosed from that spirit of pride. You are loosed from that spirit that is not of God. You are loosed from every demonic deposition into your life, everything you've ever taken that is not of God, every vow, every contract, and every oath that is made in the realm of the Spirit on your behalf. You were set free by the name of Jesus. Every soul tie that is not of God, it's broken. It's broken. It won't be broken. It is broken. It is broken. It was broken the day Jesus died on the cross. It's broken in the name of Jesus. It's broken. It's broken. It's broken. It's broken. I glorify your name, Jesus. For you are glorious and worthy to be praised. You are the Lamb upon the throne, oh, and unto you we lift our voice in praise. You are the Lamb upon the throne. For you are glorious and worthy to be praised. You are the Lamb upon the throne. Oh, and unto you we lift our voices in praise. You are the Lamb upon the throne. For you are glorious and worthy to be praised. You are the Lamb upon the throne, and not to you we lift our voice in praise. You are the Lamb upon the throne. You are the Lamb upon the throne. We plead the precious blood of Jesus, the blood that can wash us white as snow, that blood of Jesus that was shed even before the foundations of the heavens and the earth. I plead the blood of Jesus upon everybody on this line, from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. Let that blood begin to wash them. Let the blood begin to purify them. Let the blood begin to cleanse them. Let the blood begin to touch them. Every emotional issue, let the blood begin to flow to the deepest depths of their hearts and remove it. Every insecurity, let the blood begin to flow. Let it begin to flow. Let it begin to flow. Jesus, it's you. It's not me. Touch your children. He's healing you. He's healing you. He's healing you. He's healing you. Ziliba haga vadini mara ala bagaya. Kondeliba handa gabaduye inza na madali vagaya. Robandi gendili iyo undoyan zene mahaba gadole ivaya. He's healing you. He's healing you. Just receive that touch of Jesus. Receive that touch. Receive that touch. All you got to do is put your hand wherever your sickness is. If it's an emotional issue, just put your hand on your heart. If you're distressed, just put it on your heart. If you struggle with unbelief and doubt, just put it on your head. Wherever your issue is, just put your hand there and let God touch you. Let Jesus touch you. You see, he's releasing his angels, and his angels are doing the work. There's a surgery going on in the realm of the spirit right now. He's touching you. That's why I'm not even praying like that, because I want it to be all of Jesus and none of me. He's touching you. He's touching you. He's touching you. Holy Spirit, just flow. Just flow. Just flow. Let your anointing begin to flow. Let it 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 begin to flow. There's somebody here who struggles with torment. Demons torment you. If you would just cry out that name of Jesus, it'll never happen again. It'll never happen again. Zindili bahada. Oh, robogoboduli bahagadiya la bahanzo. Somebody here, you struggle with sin. There's a certain addiction that you think you can't get a grip of, and you've prayed and you've prayed and you, it's not working. If you would just cry out that name of Jesus, it'll never happen again. He'll set you free from that bondage. Everybody on this line, if you need something, if you want something from God, if you need a healing or deliverance, if you've got inbuilt hurts, deeply rooted pain and hurt in your hearts, if you struggle, if you're attacked at night by demons, whatever the issue is, just cry out that name of Jesus, and it'll never happen again. Jesus, we cry out your name this evening. Jesus, we know that it's you and you alone. Jesus, we know that we can do nothing if not by your mighty hand. Jesus, we know that if it was not by you, if you did not die 2,000 years ago, we would not receive anything that we receive this day. Jesus Christ. Rili bahanga dayandele baya bahanga. Ile bagari bahando boyandele bayandele bagaya. Jesus, we give you the glory. Jesus. 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 He who died and rose on the third day, the Alpha and the finisher of our faith, the creator of the heavens and the earth, the one true God. You are none alone, you are none other but than Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Kadi Bagadala Bayada. I want you to pray. The power of God is here. I want you to pray for a special anointing. Say, God, anoint me. Anoint me. Pour out your spirit. I don't want to be the same after this night. Not only shall I receive my healing, but I will be a vessel of healing to others. My life shall be your testimony. I shall touch, I shall lay hands on the sick, I shall cast out demons. Say, Jesus, give me that anointing. I want that oil. I want to be different. I don't want to be the same like everybody else. Say, Jesus, Holy Spirit, give me that anointing that sets me apart, that anointing that touches, that anointing that breaks your yokes, that destroys yokes, that anointing that heals the sick. Release them.
I want that strength, every bit of it, every ounce of it, every inch of it, we don't want to be the same.
Yes, Holy Spirit, I pray that you begin to pour out your anointing. Begin to activate that thing which is inside of them. Their callings and their destinies, their gifts, I pray that you activate it. I pray that you begin to stir it up. Stir up that gift. Stir up that calling. Stir up that anointing. Yes, you stir in somebody's belly. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Everybody, put your hands on your stomach. Put your hands on your stomach. Hadabadilebaya. Libahadadamandala babadalamadaya. Robali gandi gabadule ibada. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. I speak to every hindrance and every blockage, every doubt and fear and lack of faith. Be broken. Mazaba. We break through those limitations. We break through those strongholds. We break through those obstacles. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. You may feel a heat. Somebody feels a heat in your belly. Liba gabadala angata badule. Let the power of God flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Let it flow. Kaya badili bagaya. Inzala bagadaba irabahaga. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given. Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks to the Lord. Everlasting Father, we give you thanks. Not even for what you've done this night. We give you thanks for giving your Son. We give you thanks for the love of God which was proven 2,000 years ago when you died on a cross. We give you thanks for leaving us and restoring us to the presence, into the presence of God. We give you thanks for moving in our midst this evening. We give you thanks for all that you've ever done. We give you thanks. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be exalted. You are worthy to be lifted high. I give you the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. I thank you guys for being on the line tonight. I know you are touched. I know you are healed. A lot of you, as I said the other night, you're going to have dreams. People are afraid to share their dreams. Don't be afraid to share them. You're going to have dreams. God's going to show you a few things. He's going to speak to you. But we'll be back on tomorrow, same time, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Come and receive your blessing. Remember, reach out to me if you want to join the 77-day fast. It's ended September 12th, so we're past the halfway mark. If you want to join the fast, reach out to me. Reach out to somebody who can add you to the group. If you have testimonies, share them. Reach out to me. We'll have you share it, or you can just share it to me. That God touched you. Be blessed. Have a great night. In Jesus' name. Amen.